her funeral.
Yeah.
I'm certain I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through with without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the thing we
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome as we celebrate Irene's funeral and invite us to stand and join in our processional hymn. Welcome, my brothers and sisters, to this house of prayer, Irene's second home, a place where she and her husband Paul spent many, 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 many hours praying for all of us. And so it is with heavy hearts but great joy and the promise of the Lord's resurrection that we spend this time in prayer as we send the soul of this humble disciple of Christ, Irene Lang, into the arms of the God in whom she loves so much. And so on behalf of our beloved Father Ed Jankowski and all of the parishioners here, especially the members of the Catholic Women's League, I wish to extend our deepest condolences and prayers to you, Michelle and Dave, and Melanie and Sharif, to Amanda, Jade, and Sienna, to Norma, Harry, and Donald, and to all of Irene's extended family and friends here present and those who join us digitally around this altar of God as we trust in the promise of the Lord's resurrection. Indeed, this is exactly what your mother and grandmother and our sister in Christ believed in. And so we begin with the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you. On the day of her baptism, Irene was welcomed into the church, given new life in Christ, and clothed with a garment of salvation. Today we greet the ashes of our sister and surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister Irene to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made to her in baptism will be fulfilled. Let us bow our heads and call upon the mercy of our loving and gracious God that he will grant her the gift of eternal rest. You raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. You bring light to those who are in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sin and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Irene, whom you have called this day to journey to you. And since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated for the proclamation of God's holy word, and I invite Jade Ford for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. A capable wife who can find. She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She considers a field and buys it. With the fruit of her hands, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. A good wife puts her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hands to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of the idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy, her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share in the fruit of her hands and let her works praise her in the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My shepherd, and nothing do I want.
I now invite Amanda forward for our second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Let the love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love others with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Preserve in prayer. Contribute to the needs of all saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless them and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another and do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us stand for the gospel. Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God, trust also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I had gone to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, it is good for us to be here. As I mentioned, in this house of prayer, Irene's second home. Back in 2008, when I was a seminarian, Bishop Burgi sent me here for my internship, and I had the privilege of working with the now late Monsignor Vladimir and our beloved Father Ed. And two of the first people that greeted me at the door was the welcoming committee, Paul and Irene. "Are you new to Grimsby?" they asked. I said, "Yeah, you could say that. What's your name?" I said, "My name is Rico. I'm the seminarian." "Oh, we love seminarians." How many times did Irene greet you at the door of the church? Or perhaps at her home? Or perhaps at Lincoln Park? Or the other million places where we found our time with her? Irene Malcolmson Lang was a woman of hospitality. Why? Because to her very core, as this faithful and humble disciple of the Lord, she recognized that her responsibility was to love God, her family, and her friends. And throughout her 85 years here on earth, she did just that. As a loving wife and mother, a grandmother and sister, an aunt, a friend, and a sister in Christ to us all. These beautiful readings that her daughters chose for this funeral mass are very fitting. And I know Irene would blush when I say that, because if anyone knows Irene, knows how humble she was. Born on June the 15th, 1936 in Hamilton, the sixth of six in her family, with three brothers and then two sisters plus her. She began her journey with the Lord, and she recognized God's presence throughout her life. Irene often shared with me, and perhaps with all of you, "God has blessed me abundantly. I'm just so grateful," she would say. And I can't help but smile, because as we just saw in the presentation before the funeral mass, I don't think there's one time in the whole life that I've known her that I haven't seen her smile. Imagine, though, the smile on her face when she encountered the Lord Jesus face to face. This is what brings us hope at a time of sorrow like a funeral mass. And I'm sure not far behind Jesus was the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Good Counsel, and then St. Joseph, and probably fighting to get through is her beloved Paul. That reuniting as communion of saints, as this beautiful couple is reunited in God's kingdom. A couple that were married before God on October the 10th, 1959 in Hamilton. We recognize that throughout Irene's life, she lived the scriptures. "A woman who fears the Lord is to be praised," says the book of Proverbs. "Lord, give her a share in the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the city gates." Indeed, as St. Paul wrote in his letter to the Romans, "Rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer." This is Irene, who took these words and placed them as our Blessed Mother in her heart and lived by them throughout her life. Our precious mom and Gigi, Auntie Abu, often shared with us Inslee, I-N-S-L-Y, "I'll never stop loving you." What a beautiful motto to live by. Where did she get this from? The Lord Jesus, of course, who greets you, dear Lang family, with these beautiful words: "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust in me." Throughout Irene's life, even as she lost her beloved Paul, she clung to the cross and recognized that God would sustain her. We know that she worked in many different capacities in the offices of the Eaton's Company in Hamilton, Shoppers Drug Mart here in Grimsby, and at the Grimsby Travel House, looking to book happy times for many people to go on vacation. She loved writing cards to us and calling us to check in and see how we're doing. A woman who especially loved spending time with her family and friends, whether it was Scrabble or Sudoku puzzles. She loved watching TV, heaven forbid you call her during Jeopardy. A woman who loved to play tennis and was very active in our community here at St. Joseph. A woman who was also active at Lincoln Park, helping to run things, even winning Miss Congeniality Award. A woman who was a Eucharistic minister and a minister of hospitality. A woman who loved helping out as her daughters grew up in the skating club and helping with carnivals and competitions. She was a woman who was full of life. As we reflect upon her life here on earth and the great gift she was to each of us, we give honor and praise to God, for we know that death is not the end. The promise of resurrection, dear friends, is something we should all look forward to in our own lives. That beautiful encounter when the Lord Jesus calls us home to be with him forever should be something that we all look forward to. Last week we celebrated the feast of Saint Monica. Saint Monica is the patron of mothers, and especially mothers whose children have fallen away from faith. Why? Because like Monica, we are called to be persistent in prayer. How many times did Irene hear of somebody being sick or in need, and she would promise prayers for them? She had a rosary in her hand almost at all times, certainly in her purse and her pillow. Often she would pray because she trusted that the Lord would hear her prayers for those she loved and those she was called to know and love. A woman who was famous for her apple crisp and centennial squares at Christmas, who loved eating at Swiss Chalet, and of course, Bohemian Rhapsody on the radio. A woman who loved the little things in life and counted every day as a blessing from God. Lord, we thank you for the gift of Irene. We thank you for her loving presence as an awesome wife and mother. We thank you for her love as our precious Gigi. We thank you for her love as sister, as aunt, as our sister in Christ. While we mourn her passing, we recognize that she has gone to your almighty hands. And I ask that you bless the Lang family with comfort and peace. May the flame of faith that has been passed from her to them continue to create a spark and a relationship with you and with us until that day when you will call us home to be in your presence forever. For now, Lord, we ask that you show mercy upon our sister. As the scriptures remind us, eye has not seen nor has ear heard what God has ready for those who love him. And so as we place Irene in your almighty hands, O Lord, we pray that you will greet her with these words, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter now into the joy of your masters." Let us pray for our sister using the beautiful and ancient prayer of the church as we send her soul to the Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May Irene rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust in me. Dear family, hold on to the words of Jesus. May he be your comfort and your peace. My brothers and sisters in Christ, let us stand together, and I invite Sienna to come forward and lead us in our prayer of the faithful. My brothers and sisters, we know that Jesus is truly risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord, we join our prayers to his.
The response is, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
for our church and parish family, that we may be a community of hope in the promise of Lord's resurrection, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For earth's nations and people, that God will destroy the hate that divides them and bring them together in justice and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Irene, my grandma, who began eternal life in baptism, that refreshment, rest and peace may be given to her, and to all whose faith is known to God alone, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever remembering with love and affection the life of our departed sister Irene, my grandma, may she always be in our prayers as we ask God's mercy to forgive her sins, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Irene, my grandma, who mourn her passing, that God may heal their pain and give them strength to continue their own lives' journeys, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill or near death, that the compassionate Lord may be revealed to them in our prayers and charity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a few moments, now we pray in the silence of our hearts.
Lord our God, giver of peace and healer of all souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your holy people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of Irene and Paul and all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a special place in your kingdom. We ask these and all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us be seated, and as we join in our offertory hymn, I invite Bev and Ken, Leonore and Bob to the back to bring forward our gifts of bread and wine.
Always at my
Wash me, O Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my many sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Irene, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Let us kneel together. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." My Jesus, mercy. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for your help. Lord, may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gerard, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Irene, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, we remember especially Paul and all the deceased members of Irene's family. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you our God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us stand together, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Turn and offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace. Let us kneel. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from all that is evil. Keep us faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. For those at home who will receive Jesus in a spiritual communion, I invite you to pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For those here in the church who are Roman Catholic and are in a state of grace, you may come forward to receive Jesus by placing your mask in front of your face the whole time as I say the body of Christ. After you've said amen, only after you've said amen, kindly release the one side of your mask. Receive Jesus reverently on your hands. Receive him in your mouth, and then you may place your mask back over your face and return to your pews. For those who join us from other faith backgrounds, you're welcome to come forward with arms crossed like so. Leave your mask over your face for the blessing, or you may wish to continue to join us in prayer by remaining in the pews. Thank you.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Irene may come to the eternal table of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Irene. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. For one day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Jesus Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Irene shared in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. May she soon be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. And as a sign of respect for our sister, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Before the prayer of commendation, for those who are members of our parish, you know I say this not as often, only when I mean it. This church, notice there are no pillars that hold the roof up. The pillars are in the pews. And Irene is one of those pillars that we send to God. And I thought that St. Peter probably needs some help at the gate welcoming people in, because that's a good job for Irene. She is such a faithful, warm and welcoming friend of Jesus. And so we look forward to the day when the Lord Jesus will gather us all together at his eternal banquet. And so I thank you, dear Lang family, for sharing your precious mother with us, for indeed our parish has lost a very important part of our family too. May the Lord bless you and sustain you in this time. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Irene in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Jesus Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open wide the gates of paradise to your servant Irene, and help those of us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Jesus Christ and are with you and with our sister forever, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to one another be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace, let us now take our sister to her place of rest. Thanks be to God.